on. Executing now.
That's already done.
You to check the news feed next time we're at a station. Who knows? You might even find something useful to do with yourself.
Good evening and welcome to the stream. Voice text currently on mute just because I'm talking to people and I don't want it to accidentally do anything silly. Let's get this route plotted on the galaxy map and see how we go. Right, 11,000 light years and 229 jumps to the next stop. Well, not the next stop, but the next location if I want to have a look at. You never know what you might find when you're travelling the galaxy, though, so... Last time we did 30 jumps, or thereabouts. Captain's Log version 2.20 is currently up. And away we go. Voice attack enabled. Clear the area and jump.
Boost, but if we hit anything, it's not my fault. Preparing for jump.
Discovered all the planetary bodies in this system.
Well, there's not much to see here.
There is one body in this system.
Yeah, I know, it's the star.
68% of maximum.
Not for long.
You have 228 jumps left to go.
You may notice that we're still refueling at full. There we go. So under 70% for a launch. Who needs heat sinks? They're overrated when you're in a Dolphin.
Scanning for anomalies.
Now I'm not using jet cane boost because I don't like feel like repairing my ship. So this is without neutrons.
Your reserves are at 98% of maximum. You have 227 jumps left.
So let's see what we can find. Well, we have a water world. Hopefully it's a nearby one. Maybe not. Grab the asteroids. Get them out of the way. Now we can find the more interesting things. Not that ice world's particularly interesting, but hey, you gotta be completionist. Well, I do.
Electronic countermeasures, or ECMs, are used to protect the ship from missiles or torpedoes by confusing their guidance systems.
Here's, ooh, notable stellar phenomena. Let's go and have a look-see.
You have discovered all the planetary bodies in this system.
BC1, that's
you have
on.
Discovered 2 high metal content, 1 rocky body, 4 icy bodies, 1 water world, and in this system.
BC1's fairly close, so we'll go there first.
Okay.
Let's have a look at the system map. There we go. 1, 2, 3, and 4 are all within a few light seconds of the main, so we might as well scan them. Won't take long to do these. Six probes. 1, 2, 3, 4. I will finish scanning while we're on our way out.
Nicely done, Commander. You gained the efficiency bonus.
Oh, of course I did. The joys of upgraded DSS. Nice and close together.
This body. Nicely done. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Less than 7,000 kilometers apart. That's pretty close.
There are geological features on this planet.
No, I'm not surprised. Tidally locked that close together, they should be blowing each other up. No, it's pretty close when you're shooting through the atmosphere. The gravity well of one end to the next. How far away is the sun? Just there.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done. You gain the efficiency bonus. You have discovered geological surface features on this planet.
Number 3 is the one we want. Let's see what surface features are. Well, lots of them. Yeah.
Off.
Right.
Okay, here you go.
All right, I want to go for 2-1 roughly ratio. So 219, we want about 400 of them. Close enough. And down we go. All right, here I am on the second jump, and I wanted to get 200 done tonight. Too many interesting things to see in the galaxy. More like it. If you come in at a 2-1 glide ratio, you have less issues, not none, but less issues with long distances after you've dropped down. There we go, 10k's out. There's planets.
Planets. A planet is a celestial body orbiting a star or stellar remnant that is massive enough to be rounded by its own gravity, but is not massive enough to cause thermonuclear fusion and has cleared its neighboring region of planetesimals.
That looks like a nice spot to land. Landing gear.
Down and locked.
Geological site within 50 kilometers of the ship.
Deploy SRV. Deploy SRV. Oh, come on, try it again. Deploy SRV.
Transitioning to rover.
Not going to work well. You've got the power, module powered down. Funny that. Deploy SRV. Deploy SRV. No. Do it manually.
Ship into orbit.
Negative. No.
Fine.
Nothing unusual, unfortunately. Let's get back to the ship. Board ship.
Okay, executing now. Stand by. Securing the ship.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Right. Time to find us some notable stellar phenomena. clear the area and super cruise.
Engaging cruise.
Alright, targeting BC1. Moment, so we'll get out of the gravity well first. Crash points of BC1. There are notable stellar phenomena. There's one of them, and the other one should be on the other side. But we'll scan the planet first, because it's a water world and they're worth lots of money.
Lights off.
How you doing, Orange Phoenix? Where am I? I'm in the Orcox XRX B75 system. If we have a look at the galaxy map. Just outside the bubble. And heading down to there. Because it looked interesting. Then I might go over to this one. And then... No, actually, I think I might head out over this way. So over here somewhere. Here we go, might head to that one there. See how we go. Let's go back to my route. Whoop. Galaxy map.
Stellar cartography.
Oh, no, that's where I found an Earth-like world. All the way over here. No, so it's just past the Cat's Paw Nebula. Sorry, just before the Cat's Paw. Is that right? No, that's where I'm going. Actually, might drop in on the Cat's Paw Nebula on the way through. But we'll organise that when we get a little bit closer, because, I mean, we've still got a way to go. I'm trying to avoid using neutrons. Anyway. So yeah, so I just found this system and randomly came upon two notable stellar phenomena. The chances are that they're going to be crystal jumping jets or Christmas tree decorations, whatever you want to think of them as. Yeah, I sometimes think that's the best way to do it. Pick a destination and see what's out there. I mean, my eventual aim is to get Beagle Point. As you can see by the in-stream title. but this one here, yes, it was discovered, but I don't know that it's been mapped. I haven't checked. I'm not paying a lot of attention, really. Silly me. Let's have a look. Yeah, so first discovered boys. This is the solar phenomena around here. But some of them haven't been mapped. I mapped these two and that one. I missed one. Oops. I have to go back and do that. It's only a couple hundred light seconds away. These two planets are only 7,000 kilometers apart. So, nice and close. Oh, that's the main thing. Get out there, have a look at new things. Flying around in the Dolphin, I want to make sure that I've got all three space whales all the way over to Beagle Point. This will be the third one in the trip set. And I always fly back. I don't shortcut it. It doesn't feel right. I have taken the shortcut on my secondary account, but not on my primary. And that was only from Galactic Center anyway. Nope, still too far away. Six probes on this one. I think my favourite thing to do in Elite Dangerous is rescue missions from burning stations. When I want something that requires concentration, etc. But as far as relaxation and that sort of thing goes, you can't beat getting out into the black. Oh, I only need 4%. I would say that, I guess, the rear two overlapped a bit. No? Was that 6 or 8 probes? Might be an 8 probe. Alright, where's the gap at the back? At the top. That's a miss. I reckon about there. The biggest problem I'm having is that my screen is approximately 12 feet away. It is a 55-inch screen, but...
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done, Commander. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Yep. I actually enjoy flying the smaller ships. The Dolphin is just fantastic for exploration. There it is, that one. Thankfully, there's only 2 NSPs in this one. There were 3 in the last system. Well, the last system that I found them. Now, laser mode being activated. So did you actually want to go back to Colonia, or was that accidental? Yep. Yeah. Now, the first time I did the trip out to Colonia was with the Dove Enigma expedition. That was when they created the Dove Enigma station out there. Speaking of things in game, if you put your name down for having something named after you, yeah, we got Jumping Jacks again. Caltrops might be a better description of them. I think this one we've already got. Yep, already got Flavum. So 2,500 credits. Let's see if the other one's any different. Oh, don't run into me. Engage Super Cruise.
Cruise mode enabled. Now, where's that bottle opener?
Yeah, the one thing that I almost want to go back out to Colonia for is I found a system out there with several terraformable worlds and a... wrong one. Seconds. Yeah, several terraformable HMCs, water world, and an earthlike world in it. And the earthlike world was ringed. So that's sort of what I'm looking for on the way out. Speed dropping in. We've got clouds. This could be more interesting. Please show me some space lightning. Well, it looks like you're our target. There's a Presenum metallic crystals. Just having a look around to see if there's anything that's moving. Yep. I think that's the thing I like most about being out in the black, is you can get your name on something without really... Oh, hang on. Perperium. Two different types. Ooh. That's O. So Flavum, Presenum, and Purpurium all in the one system. Might head to the center of this just in case there's anything else that's interesting. Concentration. I'd say that's this way then. Lights.
Lights on.
There was one, Gord Mollusk. I bet the way I came. Hopefully it'll appear again. Goes. A new one for me. Nope. They're the same type. Let's have a closer look. See, these things actually like us. Oh, oh, there's more of them. There's a five of them now. They're very, very curious. Well, there we go. Albalum gourd mollusks found. Next system in route.
Navigation for next system.
Clear the area and jump.
I fancy a cup of tea.
Adjusting for jump. Green shift now engaged. No anomalies detected. Confirming exit point telemetry. Stand by.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm just gonna change something on the galaxy map.
Your reserves are at 82% of maximum. You have 2.
Right, where am I going to?
26. Jumps there. Left.
Yeah, what I am going to do is change that to there. Yeah, the reason for that is it will be a much more efficient jump. Might only be 4 tons of fuel, but in a Dolphin that makes a difference.
Quantum biology. A new and growing field that explores whether many biological processes
maybe
depend
we missed
on
one.
Uniquely quantum processes to work. Under particular scrutiny at the moment
yes,
are
drive.
Photosynthesis, smell, and the navigation of migratory birds.
Phenomenal.
What's the birds beyond the planet? Beyond the star. Let it range a little. Just a gas giant, but I like to make sure it's mapped. Oh, sorry, located at least.
All the planetary bodies in this system. You have discovered.
Engage FSD.
Class 2 gas giant. In this system.
Drive engage.
Yeah, I did discover one of the P or Q types, I can't remember which one it was, on the way to Colonia. There's a system which we went and visited the last time I went out there. Those things kind of drain your shields if you're not careful.
Adding information to database.
There are 8 bodies in this system. Your reserves are at 87% of maximum. You have 225 jumps left to go.
This is what I like about the Dolphin. Right, sitting at 54% on the heat.
adjusting for jump.
Didn't even hit 80%. You gotta love it when that happens.
Temperatures are at an acceptable level, except you.
And I also refueled as I was doing the jump.
Compiling data now.
There are three bodies in this system. The system's primary star is scoopable. Fuel reserves are at 92% of maximum. You have 224 jumps left to go. You have discovered all the planetary bodies in this system. You have discovered in this system.
I'll turn my shields off because it saves a little bit of heat.
Temperatures are at an acceptable level, although you're looking pretty hot.
Thank you.
Executed now.
There are 20 bodies in this system. Fuel reserves are at 100% of maximum. You have 223 jumps left.
Rocky and icy, and a high metal content. Two of them. Last two.
You have discovered all the planetary bodies in this system.
Yes, I have.
You have discovered 1 high metal content and 17 IC bodies.
Not landable and not terraformable. We'll leave that one. Yeah. Engage FSD.
Charging frameshift drive.
Information to database.
There are 2 bodies in this system. You have discovered all the planetary bodies in this system. You have discovered in this system. Fuel reserves are at 100% of maximum. You have 222 jumps left.
And it's nice to be refueling as you make your jump. No, that's all good. That's all good.
Temperatures are at an acceptable level, though you're looking pretty.
I'm going to go and grab a drink shortly anyway. I've been on for an hour.
Scanning for information.
Give me a second.
There are 9 bodies in his system. Fuel reserves are at 100% of maximum. You have 221 jumps left to go. There are 9 bodies in this system.
weaving system. So long, suckers. Key systems are at optimum levels. Readying for exit. Hold on to your seat.
Compiling data now.
You have discovered all the planetary bodies in this system. You have discovered, in this system, your reserves are at 100% of maximum. You have 220 jumps left to go. There is one body in the
course adjustment.
Forgot to turn the mic back on.
Adding information to database.
I just like the idea that I'm jumping through the exclusion zones.
There are six bodies in this system. Your reserves are at 100% of maximum. You have 219 jumps left. You have discovered all the planetary bodies in this system. You have discovered 3 high metal content, 1
yeah, not worried about
body, and in this system.
Yeah, the end in this system is a bit annoying for Mad Astra. I think it's trying to give you the stars, but it doesn't update it properly.
There are 12 bodies in this system. Your reserves are at 100% of maximum. You have 200.
Let's have a look, see.
Jumps left.
Oh, look, there's a water world. Dice World, 2 of them. The rest are high metal content by the look of it. 1, 2, 3, and 4.
You have discovered at least planetary one of them in this system. You have discovered 5 high metal content, 1 terraformable high metal content, 2 icy bodies, and 1 terraformable water world in this system.
I think we'll be mapping this one. Probably been mapped before. Yep. Right, body number one. Name on the terraformables, but yeah. By the way, that's not me moving.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done, Commander.
Yeah, well, I nearly missed it.
Bonus.
And three are probably next to each other. Yep. So we should be able to do it in 1, 2.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done, Commander. You gain the efficiency bonus.
No, we would just happen to be right in between 2 and 3. Oh well. obviously the most interesting ones are going to be the, most valuable ones. They're going to be the two terraformables, but I'm hoping to find some kind of geological features on these. Somehow I don't think so.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done, Commander. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Over there. Point 7. First, because it's the only one out this way. It does get a little frustrating sometimes how long it takes to get away from the gravity well of a planet after probing it. As soon as the planet hits reticle size, drop to zero. Six probes on this one. One. Two. Three. Four.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Let's have a look at the orrery for a change. 7, 8.
You're welcome, Commander.
Eight, six. Haven't mapped 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, and 3 I have. So what I'll do is go to 8, 6, 4, 5 and then out to 9 and then 10. No. 5. See which is closer, 5 or 6. I'd say 6 will be. No, 8, 6, 4, 5, 10. 9, 10. All right. So 8.83 time metal content, world currently worth 34,500 credits. That'll jump up to about 150 probably. Is 228 Kelvin. Impact warning, targeted. That's still far out. There we go. Oh, look, if the Orca was a medium ship, I'd never fly a Dolphin. Although the Dolphin does come in handy, it's great for when you're doing Guardian stuff, because, hang on a second, there, are the 2 points where you can put your anti-missile defense. Plus, it's a small and narrow ship, so it's easy to land on awkward terrain. But I still think with the cockpit being the size that it is, you should have a little bit more open space on it. I mean, I do like the look of all the space whales. But the Orca is definitely my favourite ship to fly. Yep, 160,000 that became worth, so 100,000 for all that massive amount of point. Now I've got 7, 9, and 10, I think. If I remember rightly. I actually had an Explorer with all the required modules on the Gnosis for anti-Xeno, should it be necessary, when that happened. It still took me 3 shots to get away from the station, though. But I've liked the Orca for ages, and then I found Ghost Giraffe's videos on YouTube. The only issue with the Orca is the fact that it's not a medium ship. It should always have been a medium ship. Yeah, that's the one. Or remember the Gnosis, whatever it is. Remember rightly, it was 4 next. Yeah, 4, then 5, then 7.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done, Commander. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Some water worlds have some features on them, but this one's not. Oops. Bumped a button.
Okay.
Hang on a second. I shall return shortly. Sorry about that. Should be next. Yep.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Now that water world, what is that one worth? 2.8 million credits. And part four ended up being 160,000, that is, not million. Now, number five, which is one we're heading to at the moment, is currently worth 420,000. Let's see what it's worth once we've scanned it. Hi, Pixie Wifey, welcome to the stream. Not bad. G'day, Mume. Welcome. Just mapping a system at the moment. A couple of terraformables in here. One was a water world. That one's returned a reasonable amount. Let's see what this one does. Very blue for an HMC. Then again, it does say that it's a pop thick carbon dioxide atmosphere.
Body. Nicely done, Commander. You gain the efficiency bonus.
I don't think it'd be very nice to look at. There's an awful lot of cloud cover there. Alright, off to map number 7. Whoop.
Dad, can you have all the points here?
I shall be right back. Dead duties required. Sorry about that. Checking out the dog's ears. The middle of summer, quite often in Australia, dogs get a bit of fly damage to their ears where they scratch it and the flies annoy them, so they scratch it some more. So we'll be picking up an ointment from the local pet store or vet tomorrow. On a completely different note, good night, Mireille. Thank you for dropping in. I'm not completely shieldless, Pixie Wifey. I've just turned them off because it saves a little bit of heat when scooping. Being in a dolphin, I get to about 75% whilst sitting in the maximum fuel zone of a star. I just turn the shields and the SRV back on when I'm landing. So yeah, what, there's some new songs that have come through on the Pretzel Rock Synthwave. If I'm not careful, they're going to put me to sleep while I'm exploring. But hey, that's the purpose of this. Chillax for a bit before we go to bed. So I don't think I'll hit the nebula tonight, spending too much time scanning planets. What's the point of exploring if you don't do some exploration? Yes, I did. Right. Back to map view. Play that one. Mapped. 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 Nine's the next one I gotta go to. Oops. Ten should be out this way as well. Yep. Alright. Full speed ahead. Shaking, what's wrong? Right, Orange Phoenix, enjoy your trip to the shop. and hopefully I'll be able to catch at least some of your stream. Like these relatively small star systems, you don't spend 15 minutes traveling between planets. Yep. I can understand that issue. My daughter suffers with it. Also causes insomnia. Oop. Double flyby. That's not good. Still, we get a close look. Six probes. One there. About 120 degrees. There's the miss. So what about there? There. Yeah. What about there? Oh, so close.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Lots of carbon dioxide rich atmospheres on this one. Alright, number 10, the last planet in the system. No, definitely not. But it's something that, unfortunately, many of us have to deal with. Wish it wasn't. And especially in trying times such as these, it makes it even harder. My wife and I went on a bit of a break for, I think it was 10 days all up. And probably spent an hour a day at least talking to the darling daughter just to keep her going through things, make sure she was okay, etc. And whenever there was a problem, 10 and 11. Yeah, there's the ring.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done. You gain the efficiency bonus.
So we got both rings. Looks like it's two. Yep. That should be to the inner one. And then off to planet 11. Systems can complete. Sorry, body scan complete. One planet left. So unfortunately, even with the rings done, those two were, or that one was only worth 5,500 credits. But without it, it wasn't worth anywhere near that much. So, currently worth 1,100. Not the right angle for this. One ring with two locations, seven probes. Should be able to do this in four. Let's see how we go. Well, I'm glad you did well at the work. My daughter suffers basically from the same ailments. Next system in route.
Selecting next destination.
Engage FSD.
Interstellar travel mode engaging now.
So my daughter's also got social anxiety and things like that, so if she's in a group that she's not sure and people rock up at the wrong time, too many people in one location, she gets issues.
Key systems are at optimal levels. Readying for exit.
Quantum theory's uncertainty principle says.
impressive, adding information to database.
There are 13 bodies in this system. Your reserves are at 89% of maximum. You have 216.
Ooh, it's an unmapped system. Well, let's have a look, see what we got. But a little bit all icy worlds, but if we get your name out there, who cares? Yep. The most important thing is to find something that you enjoy and can do comfortably, or this is what my daughter's found anyway, that she can enjoy and do regardless of what's going on around her to make things a little bit easier. One of the things she does at the moment is she plays and streams Sims 4. Which she's interacting more with other people. She keeps in contact with family and friends, etc. If not in face to face, at least via phone calls on a regular basis. And just arranges to go out when she's either absolutely has to, or to go and see specific people that she feels comfortable with. She's getting there. It's a struggle. The thing is, when you start streaming, you're putting yourself out there and you're subject to criticism from so many different angles. But it gives you that step of separation where if you need to take a step back, you can. It's the only advantage to it, I guess. But it also doesn't help when there are doctors that don't listen. Let's have a look at the system app. See if there's anything that's actually interesting. No volcanism. If there'd been something with geological or biological sites potentially on it, I would have mapped it, but...
No.
No. Okay, but get cut to my... Well, tell you what your cake is, what we'll do, the decorations.
Yep. Got the throttle up. Oh, we enjoyed your streams too, Pixies. It's nice to have somebody with a different perspective on the game. And, I think it also a little bit more difficult for you in some cases because a lot of us being native English speakers pronunciations are different, which I've always found fascinating. I love accents, but yeah, some people get frustrated. Don't understand. See, I don't speak French, but I can read a little bit of it. I still remember some things from high school. Not a lot. Most important thing I got to remember from high school was my darling wife. I think if I forgot her, I'd be in all sorts of trouble. Yeah, any language that's not your native tongue, shall we say. I've always found the Korean language fascinating.
You have discovered all the planetary bodies in this system. You have discovered.
Because the Korean alphabet is actually
rocky icy bodies in this system.
The Korean language is the Korean alphabet is phonetic in nature. So although the words look similar to perhaps Japanese or Chinese, they're not the same because they're made up of phonetic characters. No, one of my best subjects in school was French. I got 82 out of 80 on one of my tests because I got the bonus question right as well.
French is now engaged. No anomalies detected, though there is a strange smell coming from the engine room. Hyperspace. Checking systems now. Complete.
I've just always found different languages fascinating.
There are 17 bodies in this system. Your reserves are at 92% of maximum. You have 214 jumps left.
And the asteroid clusters. Hunting for the elusive, notable stellar phenomena. Alright, it looks like, yep, B's behind the sun, so... away from the plane of the ecliptic. Drop back down. Assess again. It should be behind me somewhere. There it is. Get the asteroids out of the way. Content not terraformable. Quite a small one actually, 0.06G. What am I missing? Sunsea, there it is.
Yeah.
discovered all the planetary bodies in this system.
Next.
You have discovered 2 high metal content, 12 icy bodies, and in this system.
Course adjustment. Power integrity is within limits. All other systems.
Myself, the only language I'm good at is English. And even then I have some issues. I don't like watching.
Compiling data now.
I don't even like watching subtitled movies, etc. Because I like to watch the movie and enjoy it. So I'm horrible, I prefer dubbed.
Your reserves are at 73% of maximum. You have 213 jumps left to go.
Okay, unmapped system, let's have a look. Oh, I see. Oh, there's some fueling. Away from the star. I think that's fair enough. At least want to scan it.
You have
orange rocky ice world
bodies in this system. You have discovered 6 icy bodies and 3 rocky icy bodies in this system.
Blue white. Let's see what we got here. Well, it's definitely bigger.
Adding information to database.
There are
13 bodies, and it looks like they're not mapped.
Your reserves are at 97% of maximum. You have 212 jumps.
Yep, definitely not mapped. Away from the main star. Metal contents of water world. Oh, please be an Earth-like. Yes! I've discovered Earth-like world. Oh, I think this system needs some mapping. First one of the journey. Definitely worthy of a screenshot or two. contents as well. That water world may even be terraformable. We'll see. All 13 bodies identified.
Bodies in this system. You have discovered 5 high metal content, 2 terraformable high metal content, 1 rocky body, 1 earth-like worlds, and 1 water world in this system.
Well, certainly worth having a look at. But we'll start from the beginning with A1. I always like finding Earth-like worlds. I just wish we could name worlds. Or at least submit a request to name a world. Six probes.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done. You gain the efficiency bonus.
That too. All right. I think I'll just work my way out from the start this time. To be sneaky about it, I could jump the carrier out here with me. And make sure I get my first discovery and first mapping bonuses. The only problem is my carrier charging a 25% tariff. Ah, well. The A2 is a standard high metal content. A2 is currently worth 35,000, or thereabouts. If you're wondering where I'm getting numbers from, I'm using Captain's Log version 2.
This body. Nicely done.
Number 3. Oh, 4's closer. Alright, we'll go to 4 then. Says V1, 2, and 4 will have been mapped. Four, five, eight, seven,
Galaxy.
9, 2, 6.
That's already done.
Accessing database. Stand by.
Uncertainty principle. One of the most famous ideas in science. This declares that it is impossible to know all the physical attributes of a quantum particle or system simultaneously.
Impressive.
Location, but not its velocity or vector. Well, you can know its velocity and direction of travel, but not its actual location. Is that one done?
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done, Commander. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Give me an impact warning. There we go. So should be able to get away with one on top, one on the bottom. Number 5 next.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done. You gain the efficiency bonus.
So 4 was worth 160 for A. It's worth an incredible 4,270, but it contains an awful lot of materials. So we're now on the way to 5, which currently has a value of 381,000. Which we're going to improve on somewhat.
have fully mapped this body. Nicely done. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Let's have a quick look at the artery again. Eight's next. Eight is the water world. Jump from about 350 to 1.76 million. Don't think, is it? Oh. A1 or A4 moon I can land on. Yeah, we'll see how we go. So the water world at the moment is worth 237,000. And it's got an ammonia atmosphere.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done, Commander. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Orbit lines.
Okay.
Gotta get a screenshot of that one. No, other side. Next on the list. Five, six, nine next, then seven, two, and six. orbit lines.
Acknowledged.
So my plan on this trip, if I discover a system with Earth-like worlds in it, or ammonia worlds, or multiple terraformable worlds, map the whole system, if it's a first discovery. Or if there's over 100 planets in the system, at least scan them. See how this goes. Ammonia rich atmosphere.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Alright, number 7. I think it's 7, isn't it? Yeah, 7 is the Earth light. Haven't mapped that yet. Definitely need a screenshot of that. Excuse me. It is getting late. 5 to midday. Three quarters of Earth gravity.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Orbit lines.
Acknowledged.
Let's get a bit closer. Now let's get a lot closer. That's what I want. Screenshot one. Do another boost while we're here. That'll do. Engage super cruise.
Engaging super cruise.
That's worth 3 million credits all by its lonesome. Choose next. to say that again. To take the opportunities when you get them for those screenshots. Two and then six, I think, these. Mind you, some of the high metal content worlds look nice too. This one's got 0.86G with a hot, thick carbon dioxide atmosphere. We're going to do a flyby. Ahead. Let's check the system map just in case. Three was what I needed. Which I've just flown past.
Countermeasures, or ECMs,
three and six.
To protect a ship from missiles or torpedoes by confusing their guidance systems.
Oops. Wait.
not fair.
Please don't fly by. Orbit lines.
Affirmative, Commander.
Thank you.
You're welcome, Commander.
Alright, number 6.
You have fully mapped this body. Nicely done. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Caution, feeling, co-pilot approaching. Come on then, Dash. Come on. There you go, big room for you. This one's currently worth 400,000 after scanning, sorry, probing.
This body. Nicely done, Commander. You gain the efficiency bonus.
Alrighty, once the system's gained. Next system in route. Let's try that again. Next system in route.
Locking system destination.
Engage FSD.
There are three bodies in this system. The system's primary star is scoopable. Fuel reserves are at 75% of maximum. You have 211 jumps left. You have discovered all the planetary bodies in this system. You have discovered 1. High metal content in this system.
2. Locking next star system. Integrity is within limits. All other systems are at normal levels. Hyperspace. Checking systems now. Complete.
Scanning now.
There are 21 bodies in this system. Fuel reserves are at 100% of maximum. You have 210 jumps left.
Bam bodies, let's check the FSS. A little bit of everything. Not everything, but let's get the asteroids out of the way. More asteroids. Behind the sun. Why does that not surprise me? Alright, two hell metal contents. One left.
You have discovered all the planetary bodies in this system. You have discovered 6 high metal content, 1 terraformable high metal content, 1 rocky body, 8 icy bodies, 2 rocky icy bodies, and in this system.
However many stars that leave remaining. Alright, so look, system map. Closest thing to, I can land on is over there. It's only that one that's capable of supporting anything. Alright, that's it for this evening. Thank you very much for watching. Have fun, be safe, and fly enthusiastically. 07 all, and out.